Jason Dewey is physically strong and mentally resilient. Jason Dewey knows a lot about video games. He's taught me a lot about video games. I couldn't tell you exactly what he's taught me, but it certainly feels like he's taught me a lot. Jason Dewey is a sharp dresser. Jason is a kind person. He once offered to get me something from our toast bar, our cafeteria, and it was really, really nice of him. You know, it can be really stressful on the galleries, dealing with people all the time. So he was like, do you want a cup of tea or a cup of coffee? And so he went, I said, yes, tea please. He went away. And so actually he didn't bring me anything back. I think he forgot. I didn't see him again the rest of the day actually. But it was a nice thought. Would have liked it, that tea. I am a good guy, and I feel confident in saying that because Jason taught me about self-esteem, because he is so sure that he is great at everything. And at first I thought it was a little bit arrogant, but actually, you know, it's kind of admirable. If you can like yourself so much, it doesn't really matter if anybody else likes you. And that's certainly his philosophy. So, Jason is a very dedicated member of staff here at the National Video Game Arcade. He's so dedicated to his responsibilities and to his duties, whatever it is that they are, whatever it is that he actually does here. I've never seen Jason personally, but he certainly seems like he's a hard worker from what he was telling me before I agreed to do this. If you liked Jason in the right way, he is passively attractive. Jason once told me that so I think Jason is best summed up like a brick. Solid thing here you got there, little solid brick. Useless on its own, but very useful with lots of other bricks. And that's really how I would describe Jason. It really is. Jason's like a traffic light, always stuck on amber. He's always ready to go, but he never quite makes it. If you take Jason on, we will be losing an employee, and you will be gaining an employee.
Oh yeah, okay, yeah, so yeah, Jason Video Games. He obviously knows a lot about video games. I mean, just the other day I was wearing this shirt and we did a little quiz because this is, you know, Marvel vs. Capcom 3, a bunch of characters from a bunch of different games together, and I told them, can you guess which games these characters are from? I pointed this one, and I don't think he got this one. That's Chris from, I don't think he got that one either. He did get Spider-Man. Oh wait, no, that's Deadpool. He did get the all from Marvel vs. Capcom 3 though. And that is on the top of the shirt. That's something that's important. Eye for detail. He can read. So, Jason, he's a philosopher. He's taught me a lot about life. He once told me that life is like a light switch. I didn't know what he meant by that. Obviously, it was quite deep and profound, way over my head. I guess it could be something to do with... No. Anyway, it changed my life forever. So, while we're working, tend to give, because Jason's a bit older than the rest of us, tend to give him a bit of a ribbing. I think he's like 20 years older than us, in his 40s, I don't know. I mean, we made so many jokes that we've actually genuinely forgotten how old he is. 40? No. Yeah, I mean, I had a lot of good times with Jason. We spent a lot of time playing board games together. He's a good friend. There's one time we're playing Articulate. Don't know if you know the game. Essentially, you have to explain a word to someone without actually using the words. One of my friends explaining to Jason something that you play sport with, where you hit something over a net. Jason correctly identified the sport as tennis. Unfortunately, he forgot that you don't play like baseball with a bat. You play with a racket. So he very passionately shouted, "Tennis bat." That's something we'll never let him forget. I guess it shows quick thinking, a tendency to jump in, even though you don't know exactly what you're doing. I guess that's admirable. Jason once offered to take me to the beach. I didn't really know how to take it, but it's a nice gesture. Sorry.
To the beach.
So it's a weird thing, but I guess we're looking for unique things here about Jason. There's contagious laughter when people yawn. Some people say it's contagious. When Jason farts. I can't.
Sorry.
I couldn't do it.
Okay. I'm fine.
You said you weren't ridiculous.
I might just make a compilation of what things are.
Jason showed me how to flip a cassette tape. I didn't know that the two different sides had two different things on it. Obviously, he's from a different era to me. I had my granddad, he had cassettes. And obviously, Jason was around at the same time. And he showed me exactly what it was like back in the day when we didn't have things like electricity or music. I'm running out of ideas, obviously. Jason has a lot of hobbies, obviously video games. He plays a lot of video games. He collects what he likes to call antique rocks. He's got them from quite a few time periods. Victorian era rocks, we got French Revolution rocks. I don't know how he can tell that they're from the places and times, but he's gone into quite a bit of detail, something about carbon dating or is it carbon in rocks? I don't know. Anyway, hobbies.